his act being 7 inches. At first, the inmate, mewling and puking in the nurse's arms, and then the whining schoolboy, with his satchel and shining morning face, creeping like a snail unwillingly to school. And then the lawyer, sighing like Ferris with a woeful battle made to his mistress's eyebrow. Then a soldier, full of strange oaths and bearded like a pard. Jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble reputation, even in the cannon's mouth. Then the justice, in fair round belly with good cape and line, with eyes severe and beard a formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances. And so he plays his part. The sixth age shifts into the lean and slippered pantaloon, with spectacles on nose and pouch on side. His youthful hose well saved, a world too wide for his shrunk shank, and his big and manly voice turned again on childish trump, the pipes and whistles in the sound. Last scene of all, that ends this strange, eventful history, is second childishness and mere oblivion. Sends teeth, sends eyes, sends taste, sends everything.